Today we have to start our third unit. First unit, the national income and related aggregates. Second unit, money and banking. We already finished so far. So today we have to start our the topic determination of income and employment. In the third unit, your first subtopic should be aggregate demand. Dear students, first we have to clear about the concept of our unit, that is determination of income and employment. See the relation between income versus employment. My dear students, when we study about the concept of macroeconomics, we already discussed in the introductory classes. Here, question remains unchanged. Problems of the economy remains unchanged. What changes? The method of solution adopted by a different economy. So, what are the challenges here? To raise income, employment, output. Challenges of macroeconomics. इसकी मैक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स व्हाट आर द चैलेंजेस वेज आउटपुट इनकम aspects we have to deal in detail. Output, income and employment. Between output and income, our concept is output means it's a real income and income that is nominal. Since the term output and income both representing the income, we have to take only the income in this topic. What are the difference between nominal and real? Nominal income based on monetary values of goods and services. That it depends on price of the goods and services. But real income is based on real production of goods and services. So it doesn't matter whether we talk about real or nominal. Both represented by income. So in this segment we have to study about income and employment, which create more challenges before each and every economy of the world. So what we have to do, or what are the ideas behind it? To mention determination of income and employment in an economy. So dear students, here our observation is, higher the income, higher the employment, lower the income, lower the employment. You can say, there is a direct link between income and employment generation. So, if our economy is able to increase the level of income, she will be able to raise the level of employment also. So, the concept is that we have to raise both income as well as employment. In this segment, whenever we deal in details, we have to discuss about a lot of concepts, aggregate demand, aggregate saving, saving function, gross investment, net investment, a lot, etc. So, today, we have to start our first sub-component, aggregate demand. So, see the concept of aggregate demand. I mean, we have to start with the concept of aggregate demand. Dear student, whenever we talk about demand, so question has been arrived in the minds of everyone, because all the students of class 12 already are having its proper knowledge regarding the term demand. All the students of class 12 already studied the concept of demand, not aggregate demand, in class 11 in the book of microeconomics. So, first of all, we have to realize what the difference or similarity between demand and aggregate demand, where we have to start by discussing about demand versus aggregate demand. Demand, a concept of microeconomics. Aggregate demand, a concept of macroeconomics. So, come to the topic to analyze or compare both the concepts. One associated with micro, that is class 11, and another associated with macro, that is class 12. Here, demand related to individuals. It means demand for individual consumer or demand of individual products or demand in an individual market. Whenever we have to discuss the demand in case of microeconomy, what we require? Individual consumers, individual product, individual market, or group of consumers, or
demand in microeconomics.
in microeconomics, demand refers to quantity of output that a consumer has planned to purchase at a particular price and particular time. But right now, we are here to study about aggregate demand. So, compare aggregate demand with the demand. First is micro and macro. Means micro is a small level and is large scale. Okay, so here individual consumer. No. In place of individual consumer, you have to study about all the consumers. All the consumers. Individual product, no. In case of product, all the goods as well as services. Unmarked. Entire economy. A group of consumers, not a group, all of the consumers, an identical product or substitute, no, all the products, and a group of home industry, no, all the industries. Entire economy means all the industries, all the industries. So here in case of micro, you have to discuss about the demand at given price, time, given price and time. Given price and time. Here price means price of individual goods. Time means at given period of time. See, in case of aggregate demand, their price means general price. Here, in case of micro, what we discuss at a particular price, a product good X, so good X ki a particular price. But here, in case of macro, there is no single goods. It's a lot of goods. You can say the millions of goods and services available in the market. So, nobody is ever to identify a particular price for all the goods and services. So, price of all the goods and services considered at general price level. Pen ki price kya hai? Pencil ki kya hai? Eraser or cut? Sharpening ki price kya hai? Book or copy ki price kya hai? Doesn't matter. We have to talk about a general price level. What the tendency of price in the market, whether it's rising or declining. We have to discuss about trend or tendency of prices of all the products. So here we have to discuss about at a general price level. So dear student, the demand in micro and demand in macro, these are the differences. See the similarity or the most common features in between two. Here, demand is a component. Is a component. of aggregate demand. Demand is a proper subset of aggregate demand. It belongs to aggregate demand, or you can say sum total of demand of all the goods and services are called aggregate demand. Mean, whenever we talk about in absence of individual demand, there is no hope for aggregate, and if aggregates are given, there is a place of individual. So both are interlinked, both are depends on each other, both are mutually related to each other. Micro component is a proper subset of macro, and sum total of micros constitute the value of macro. So this is the similarity and dissimilarity between demand in micro as well as in macro. But here must remember that whenever we talk about demand in macro, you have to use the term aggregate demand only. Don't try to use the word demand in case of macro. In case of macro, only aggregate demand is a relevant term to be used in the concept. So, dear student, come to the topic aggregate demand. Concept or concept of aggregate demand. As we discussed, it doesn't refer to the demand of any particular goods. जब एग्रीगेट डिमांड पढ़ेंगे तो किसी पर्टिकुलर गुड को नहीं पढ़ेंगे. इट इज द डिमांड फॉर ऑल द गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज हॉल टाइम. यहाँ क्या पढ़ा गिवन टाइम इन अ फाइनेंशियल ईयर. नेक्स्ट इट्स इंक्लूड डिमांड ऑफ ऑल द गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज. सेकेंड एटी इज मेजर इन अ पर्टिकुलर पीरियड ऑफ टाइम दैट इज अ फाइनेंशियल और एन अकाउंटिंग ईयर. In case of microeconomic, demand measured at a given period of time, but here the time is one specific financial or accounting year. So aggregate demand is measured during a period of 1 year. That period is popularly treated as accounting year or financial year. In case of microeconomics, we already discussed demand is measured at the price of the product, depends on price of the product. But here, our aggregate demand is the function of either general price level or it's a function of income. Must remember, GP stands for general price level. Y stands for disposable income. So, dear student, here there are two concepts we have to discuss. Either AD depends on general price level or AD depends on level of income. In case of micro, we discussed about demand depends on price of X, price of that product only. But here, if we discuss about AD with respect to first equation, first and second, if function of general price level, there is negative relation. क्या कहते हैं? Negative or inverse relation. But whenever we talk about AD with respect to level of income, direct or qualitative relation.
the meaning of the two?
Aggregate demand depends on general price level. If general price level determines the level of demand, you can say higher the price, lower the demand, lower the price, higher the demand. Ek high hoga, dusra low hoga, ek pehla low hoga, dusra high hoga, that's why. Then inverse relation. Higher the general price level, lower the demand. Lower the general price level, higher the demand. So, you can convert the relationship into inverse. But whenever we talk about aggregate demand, depends on level of income. It's a function of income. What can you say? Here, our aggregate demand directly linked, not indirectly linked. Here, our aggregate demand directly linked with the level of income. Higher the level of income, higher the demand for the product. Lower the level of income, lower the demand for product. That's why all the goods and services. So, whenever we discuss about level of relationship between AD and level of income, you can say there is positive or direct link between two. In our syllabus at plus two level, ignore that relation. अब हमें केवल डिस्कस करनी है एग्रीगेट डिमांड इज द फंक्शन ऑफ लेवल ऑफ इनकम. हियर वाई स्टैंड फॉर जनरल इनकम लेवल, इनकम फॉर ऑल द इकोनॉमी. अगेन सी द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ मेजरमेंट, हाउ टू मेजर एग्रीगेट डिमांड. Measurement in, if possible, one in volume of product and second in value of the products. जब भी हमें measure करनी है, there are two approaches available with us. एक कितनी quantity produce हुई, wheat कितनी produce हुई, rice कितनी produce हुई. बिल्डिंग कितने कंस्ट्रक्ट की गई, ब्रिजेज कितने कंस्ट्रक्शन हुए, सबकी क्वांटिटी मेजर कर लें इन वॉल्यूम. और वी हैव टू एक्सप्रेस दीज वॉल्यूम इन टर्म्स ऑफ वैल्यू. सो देयर इज टू मेथड वी हैव टू मेजर आवर एग्रीगेट डिमांड. वी सेलेक्ट द सेकेंड वैल्यू ऑफ गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज, नॉट द वॉल्यूम ऑफ गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज. इन बिटवीन टू our measurement criteria is based on value of all the goods and services. Value of all the goods and services is considered while calculating the aggregate demand. Second, there are two approaches, plant and realize. X and T, X post. X and T, X post. One is planned, another is realized. The way that we have to discuss about planned people wishes to spend or realized people actually spend. So dear students, in between two, we have to consider about the planned approach. People have planned to spend the money on purchase of goods and services subject to general price level during a period of financial year. So, dear student, you can define the concept AD is the sum total of expenditures. But AD, because we are considering the value of the goods, AD is some total of expenditure that the people plan to incur, not actually incurred. Some total of expenditure that people plan to incur on the purchase of all the goods and services, not a single goods, all the goods and services in the economy during the period of an accounting year, not at a particular point of time, corresponding to different level of income. So, dear students, we whenever we discuss about aggregate demand, it refers to total expenditure. Total expenditure that people have planned. That plan people have planned to expend the total expenditure that people have planned to expend on all the goods and services during financial year. At corresponding level of at or corresponding to level of in. So dear listener, try to conclude our concept with development of our definition for aggregate demand. Our aggregate demand refers to some total of expenditure that people have planned to incur on purchase of all the goods and services produced during a financial year corresponding to general level of income. So, these are the concept of aggregate demand. Whenever we discuss about the component, we have to discuss about all four sectors of economy. So, right now, for today, it's over. In the next class, we discuss about component and behavior of aggregate demand. So, for today, thanks all. We'll meet in the next class.